Hello, green-eyed monsters! Here I am again, your Mommy Eye from the Philippines. And welcome back to my YouTube channel, Mommy Potter the Plant Witch. For today's video, day 29 of 30 houseplant care, I am featuring Pilea Care Tips. Pilea is the largest genus of flowering plants in the nettle family, Urticaceae. The majority of species are succulent, shade-loving herbs or shrubs. It is a genus consisting of frost-tender, tropical foliage plants, including both upright, bushy types and trailing varieties. Several smaller species are commonly cultivated as houseplants because they are easy to grow and care for. They make great starter plants for inexperienced growers. In general, these plants are moderate to fast growers. Pilea foliage varies considerably, ranging from 3-inch textured and lunch-shaped leaves to tiny heart shapes and moss-like foliage. Pileas occasionally bloom, but their pink or cream flowers are very tiny and often go unnoticed. To better identify pileas, here are some examples. Pilea cajerei, the aluminum plant, which has silvery splashes on its green and oval toothed foliage. And the Pilea involucrata, the friendship plant, which have velvety leaves that are deeply crinkled and veined. Pileas are fairly low maintenance and forgiving plants. If you are interested in growing them as houseplants, Mommy Potter will give you the basic care tips. On lighting conditions suited for pileas. Most pilea species like bright, indirect light. Pilea can tolerate low light, but its foliage will turn a darker green and it will become leggy. Mommy Potter tips! Do not expose them to direct sun as this can burn the leaves. Make sure to rotate the pot as the plant will stretch toward the sun and begin to grow lopsided if you don't. The best potting medium to grow pileas. Pilea plants prefer a moderately rich, well-draining potting mix. Soggy soil can cause root rot and kill a plant. Mommy Potter tips! A peat moss-based potting mix with added perlite is beneficial for this plant. Make sure that these plants are planted in a pot with drainage holes. The watering schedule and requirements. Pilea plants have medium to high water needs. Water whenever the first inch of the soil dries out. Mommy Potter tips! If you notice that the leaves are drooping, it indicates that your plant needs more water. Water until it pours out of the drainage holes of the pot. Pests and diseases affecting pileas. The pilea is normally pretty good at resisting pests, but small ones like thrips or aphids may still try and set up home in your plant. Also, curling and yellowing of the leaves and root rot may affect your plants. Mommy Potter tips! Remove the insects manually by using cotton buds dipped in rubbing alcohol. Also, cut away all the leaves and stems that are heavily infested and spray it with diluted neem oil. Monitor watering schedule to avoid root rot and yellowing of the leaves. So, what are you waiting for? After learning the basic care tips of pileas, grow one in your homes and enjoy the magic of planting!